Also visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So on Saturday's lecture, we in detail discussed the operation of full bridge inverter with RL load. And then we studied the four performance parameters of inverters. That is harmonic factor of the nth harmonic, total harmonic distortion. And we learned an important formula that the square of the overall RMS value of load voltage is a summation of the square of the harmonic voltage VL and the square of the RMS value of fundamental. So this formula is very important from the numericals viewpoint. And we had distortion factor and we had lowest order harmonic. And then we studied what is Cauchy square wave inverter. So it is an inverter whose load voltage waveform is mathematically a Cauchy square wave. And we had defined the Cauchy square wave something like this, which is in front of us. The Cauchy square wave, similar to a square wave, is symmetric about the x-axis over one cycle. And it is having two pulses and the pulse width is 2 delta. And this wave is symmetric about the quarter point, that is pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2. So the conventional Cauchy square wave is a Cauchy square wave in which 2 delta is equal to 120 degrees or 2 pi by 3 radians. So if we take 2 delta as 120 degrees, then there will be a pulse from 30 degrees to 150 degrees having a value plus V in the positive half cycle, and there will be another pulse from 210 degrees to 330 degrees with value equal to minus V in the negative half cycle. So for a generic Cauchy square wave, the Fourier analysis showed that An is equal to 0 for all values of N, and Bn is equal to 4V upon n pi into cos n pi by 6 for all values of n which are odd but not triple n harmonics. So how Cauchy square wave is different than square wave is that a square wave has all odd harmonics. So it has the harmonics 3rd, 5th, 7th, 9th, 11th. But in a Cauchy square wave, the 3rd, 9th, 15th, these harmonics are not there because these are triple n harmonics or multiples of 3. So in a Cauchy square wave, the third harmonic is not present, but in a square wave, third harmonic will be present. Okay. So we had justified that a Cauchy square wave is superior to square wave because its harmonic content is lesser. So the RMS value of a conventional Cauchy square wave is equal to 0.81 times V, that is 81% of V. If you remember that the RMS content of a square wave is equal to V, okay? But that in case of a Cauchy square wave is 0.81 times V. So we can see that the RMS value of the fundamental component of a Cauchy square wave is 81% of the input voltage, while in case of square wave it is 90%. So as such, the RMS value of fundamental component of Cauchy square wave is 9% lesser than square wave, but still we consider it more because its harmonic content is less. Okay. So we take our discussion further today. we know that Cn is equal to 4v upon n pi cos of n pi by 6 for all n equal to 1, 5, 7, 11, 13, etc. Okay, so VLN peak, that is the peak value of nth harmonic of the load voltage, is equal to 4V upon n pi into cos n pi by 6. Therefore, the RMS value will be peak upon root 2 So, the peak and RMS values of fundamental component R VL1 peak is equal to VLN peak for n equal to 1 is equal to 4v upon n pi, n is equal to 1, cos of n pi by 6, which is equal to 1.1 times V, and VL1 RMS will be equal to VLN RMS for n equal to 1. It's not needed like that. We can directly also do it like this. Equal to VL1 peak upon root 2 0.78 times V. harmonics. All odd harmonics. And here, all odd harmonics except triplet harmonics. VL1 RMS 0.9 times V. Harmonic factor for a square wave is 0.48 or 49%. Here it is 0.309 or 30.9%. Cross conduction between cross conduction between transistors. So when I say cross conduction, it is between Q1, Q2 and Q3, Q4. Yes, it is possible and should be avoided using guard band. Totally absent. You know why? Because in a square wave inverter, we know that from 0 to pi Q1, Q2 conduct, and from pi to 2 pi Q3, Q4 conduct. So at this moment, at omega t equal to pi, if Q1 and Q2 do not completely turn off, and by the time Q3, Q4 come inside the circuit, then for some period of time called as overlap period, all four transistors will be conducting. Okay, so make a correction here. It is omega t. But here this is not the case, because Q1 and Q2, they will turn off at pi by 2 plus delta, and the next pair Q3, Q4 will start conducting at 3 pi by 2 minus delta. So there is a lot of ready-made gap available. So if you calculate the time period between 150 degrees and 210 degrees, then this is sufficient for avoiding overlap. Totally absent. You can make a point that control circuit for square wave inverter is simple, while here it is complex. Okay. So the next topic is called as PWM inverters. So this can be defined similar to square wave or quasi square wave inverters. That is, the load voltage waveform has a PWM nature. Okay, so now PWMs can be defined, PWMs can be classified in many different ways. At least in our syllabus, there are three classifications of PWM given. Okay. SPM, MPM, and sinusoidal PWM. SPM stands for single pulse modulation. MPM stands for multiple pulse modulation. So if you come to know how SPM, MPM and sinusoidal PWM are generated, we can automatically understand that why these kinds of PWMs have got their name: single pulse, multiple pulse and sinusoidal PWM. So all of you know, students, that there is one particular element which is called as a comparator. And you know that operational amplifiers or op-amps can be used as comparators. So you know that this particular principle can be used. So if we know that this is an op-amp, here, okay. So the voltage applied at this terminal is called as non-inverting terminal. Where is not non-inverting? Inverting. This is non-inverting, and this is VO. Okay. So we know that VO is equal to plus VSAT if the non-inverting terminal voltage is greater than inverting terminal voltage, and is equal to minus VSAT if V non-inverting is less than V inverting. Okay, and then mod of VSAT is approximately 95% of VCC. Okay. So this is a comparator. So one general principle which applies to SPM, MPM and sinusoidal PWM is as follows. Are first is the carrier signal C, and second is called as a reference signal. R. So understand this carrier signal has two attributes, the amplitude of carrier and frequency of carrier, and the reference signal has two attributes, that is amplitude of reference and frequency of reference. Okay, so the ratio of AC and AR will decide the modulation index M. Similarly, if it is frequency modulation, we have the modulation index of the frequency modulation. Okay, so you will see these terms AC, FC, AR and FR in the waveforms for single pulse modulation, multiple pulse modulation, also sinusoidal PWM. So now we draw the waveforms for SPM. This is my reference signal. So first we draw the markers pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. So this has to be seen carefully. This is the carrier amplitude. See how I draw it now. Okay, so this is a very typical kind of a carrier signal which is very difficult to generate using electronic circuits. And when you see what is the output of this comparison, you will come to know that yes, that is why we say that Cauchy square wave control circuit is complex in nature. Now students, see here. This is my reference signal. And this amplitude is AR. Okay, here you see. So AR is amplitude of reference signal, which is denoted by fluorescent green horizontal line. And the carrier signal has an amplitude plus AC to minus AC. Okay. Yeah. And we can give either the reference signal or the carrier signal to one of the inputs, that is inverting or non-inverting inputs of the operational amplifier. And after comparison, this is what we get. Okay, so the carrier signal is continuously compared with the reference signal in real time, and this is what we get. Okay, see now how I'm drawing it. this is a quasi square wave. So we can say the waveform for output voltage shows that it is the generic quasi square wave. So quasi square wave output is also called as single PWM, single pulse PWM. Okay, it's very clear here that if I increase the levels of plus AR and minus AR, okay, so if I increase the levels of plus AR and minus AR, the value of 2 delta will be varied. Okay, so this is the time period of carrier, which is equal to 1 over frequency of carrier. You can also say that the value of 2 delta can be varied by changing the levels plus AR and minus AR, and the frequency of output voltage can be varied by varying FC, which is equal to 1 over time period. So the mathematical analysis of SPM is exactly same as quasi square wave. Okay, we multiple pulse. Okay. So students, one more reason is that why this is called as a single pulse PWM, because we are having only one pulse per half cycle of the output. So yeah, let me explain it here. So this is called as one half cycle, and this is called as a second half cycle. Okay. So we have only one pulse from 0 to pi, and we have only one pulse from 0 to pi, from pi to 2 pi. So we can say here that one pulse per half cycle. Why it is called a single pulse? Because there is only one pulse per half cycle. And in similar lines, we can define here as multiple pulses per half cycle. So again, we are going to draw the carrier signal and the reference signal. So how many cycles I have drawn here? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Similarly, from pi to pi again I have to draw 4 cycles. One, two, three, four. Again, from 2 pi to 3 pi 1 2 3 4 okay My half cycle completes here. Half cycle completes here. Okay. Reference signal. Students, this is carrier. This is reference. Okay. Now you see how we get multiple pulses per half cycle. So there are multiple comparisons. So which are the comparison instants? See here. These are the points of comparison. Okay. So pi by 2, pi, three pi by 2, 2 pi, 2 pi. Here we will get a pulse between these two. Okay, see how I get it now. First pulse, second pulse, third pulse, fourth pulse, and again. Again, I get a pulse here. Again, here. Because I myself have not drawn it symmetrically, that is why it is coming like this. Sorry, it will not come like this. It will come here. ओके सो वेयर इज माय फर्स्ट हाफ साइकिल फर्स्ट हाफ साइकिल सेकेंड हाफ साइकिल ओके सो वी कैन सी हियर हाउ मेनी पल्सेस आई एम गेटिंग वन टू थ्री फोर ओके सेकेंड हाफ साइकिल फाइव सिक्स सेवन एट अदर हाफ साइकिल इफ आई काउंट नाइन टेन इलेवन यू विल गेट वन मोर ईयर ट्वेल्व ओके सो स्टूडेंट्स वी आर सीइंग हियर द वेवफॉर्म फॉर वी ओ shows that we have four pulses per half cycle. Okay. So let us specify here that half cycle means zero to pi, pi to two pi, etc. So again here, if I increase or decrease this level AR, then the width of the pulses will change. And if I change the frequency, okay, we can see that this is the frequency of the carrier. This is TC. So if I reduce the time period, I will have more number of pulses. So another important conclusion is by changing the level AR, pulse widths can be changed and why changing the frequency FC which is equal to 1 over TC of the carrier signal Disadvantages of this system are that switching losses increase.